Hello everyone, it's me again. I hope that you managed to work yourself away through the block on vibrations of strings and that you indeed saw that it is quite different than discrete systems. The fact that we have to work with these displacement functions rather than generalized coordinates really makes for a difference, as the equation of motion is now a partial differential equation. However, using this technique of separations of variables and modal analysis, the final form of the modal equations is exactly the same as what we had for discrete systems. So we can still use similar solution strategies. So in the next block, we are going to look at the vibrations in bars, axial vibrations in bars. And this will be the first time that we are really looking into a structural member. What I would like to point out before we start this block is that the thing that is fundamentally different from vibrations in strings is the physics of the equation of motion. So the fact that we have a bar, not a string, that makes for a difference in terms of the properties that are involved. However, we will see that the equation of motion, once we get there, has the same mathematical form as the equation of motion of a vibrating string. It is also this so-called wave equation. That means that although the parameters that are in this equation are different, actually the same solution strategy applies as to vibrations of strings. So I hope that as we go through this block, which will in total be 6 lectures, that you will recognize some of the math. And I don't think, I think it's a good idea that we repeat this, but I hope you will recognize some stuff such that you can actually focus your attention to what is different. How do we end up with this equation of motion? What do the boundary conditions physically mean? So before we turn our attention to deriving the equation of motion, I think it is good that we start off by discussing what is the kinematic model. What are we talking about when we discuss bars? So for that, I brought a small test setup. First of all, these bars, they are considered to be a slender member, such that means that the length is typically an order of magnitude larger than the height and the width. All right, so that's an important thing. We are going to look only at elastic deformations that are small and also that the strains remain small. So if you focus now on the grid that is painted on this bar, look what happens when I apply an axial load to this bar. You will see that the grid lines that are initially vertical, they remain vertical throughout the deformation. So that means that a cross-sectional plane does not deform. It will move as a rigid plane. So that is the fundamental observation here. The bar gets longer or shorter if we press. And that can be described by the axial deformation at every location in the bar, so as a function of x, which may also change in time as this external load might vary in time. Okay, so these are the fundamental kinematic assumptions on the displacement field. And then we need some relations from elasticity theory or mechanics of materials to end up with the equation of motion. So that is what I will do in this first lecture. I will also show you that this equation of motion can be used to solve static problems, of which you maybe have seen the solution before in earlier courses. And after that, I will show you how to determine natural frequencies and modes, and how we can use modal analysis to establish the free and forced vibration response of these axial vibrations in bars. So again, 6 lectures, quite some work. You will recognize, I think, the same structure as with strings. Good luck. I will see you again in the next video. Bye-bye.